then she goes back down the stairs while he goes on.
Okay.
He's talking. So he was always filling with contraptions and knew a lot about signaling and stuff, but not so much about electronics. When he went to college, he went into engineering first and then into, but instead that sort of cut and dry, like all the formulas had already worked out about how engineering was supposed to work. So all the action was in physics, so he got into physics, like his father, I guess, and got interested in terrestrial magnetism and sunspots and a lot of these things. And a lot of the kind of research he wanted to start wanted to do had to do with statistics, and that's when he first started calculating. So in college, he was dealing with machines like this. This was state-of-the-art here. This was one of his first calculators. It's a desk calculator. And he had a slide rule, of course, before this, but they're not very accurate. This is actually a digital machine. Pretty cool in this time. You could type a number in, put it in an accumulator, and then you type another number in, and it would add it to it. And that was the problem. Now you got a number in there. The only way to store it was to copy it out in paper. The whole thing had, and when people did extensive calculations, they were constantly copying things from paper, typing them in, copying it back to the paper, and then typing it in again. And so it was labor intensive and also prone to errors. Sometimes you can copy the right number. So he started thinking about this, and he was always, I think it is always the way with gadget guys. When you're using a gadget, you're always thinking about some better way that you could use that gadget, or some better way to do it. Like you're wasting your time. If only something. So he started fiddling around. He got his job as he got out of college at our science. He was the physics department. He was the only physics professor there. So he was the whole department. And I taught physics at our science college, which is just over the river in Pennsylvania. And in his spare time, he started fiddling around. He was trying to do research. He was trying to accelerate it. And he was using his desk calculator when he could. Sometimes he would hire students to type things into his desk calculator. And he was working, as I said, on the problems to do with sunspots and how sunspots affect the weather. Something that's still in the press. People are still thinking that maybe global warming is just sunspots.